Finally, Iran is ready to return to the negotiating table with the United States, says President Hassan Rouhani, but only provided that Washington lifts sanctions on Tehran first. Specifically, the Ayatollah government wants to remove the heavy sanctions on Iran's crude oil exports imposed when the U.S. left the JCPOA nuclear deal in 2018. And now, in taking diplomacy efforts seriously, Washington has granted a visa application to Iranian Foreign Minister Mohammad Javad Zarif so that he can at least attend a United Nations meeting in New York. His movements will be limited, though, to just six city blocks, which include the Iranian embassy, the ambassador's residence, and the UNHQ, all while European foreign ministers and government leaders meet in Brussels on Monday to try and come up with a way to keep both Iran and the U.S. in the JCPOA. One European diplomat even recently said that the deal is on the brink, with the intent on Monday to show unity, but also to convey the message to Iran to come back into line. Meanwhile, however, the White House is looking to Iran's diplomatic sincerity with a grain of salt, as United States Secretary of State Mike Pompeo rejected President Rouhani's rhetoric as more of the same offered to former Secretary of State John Kerry and President Obama, who first entered into the JCPOA in 2015. Additionally, seemingly as a contingency plan of sorts, both the UK and the United States have announced the increasing of military forces in the Persian Gulf. This as violent tensions continue to rise in the background, especially following the alleged Iranian attempt at intercepting a British oil tanker, which in turn followed the UK's interception of an Iranian tanker off the coast of Gibraltar and the attack on a series of Saudi vessels as well.